Warm morning to all the students. This is your computer teacher Devdeep sir, and we are starting off a new chapter today, and the name of the chapter is Microsoft Excel. Now children, have you heard about the word spreadsheet? Let me tell you that Microsoft Excel is a spreadsheet program, okay? Now Microsoft Excel is a spreadsheet program. What is the use of this spreadsheet program that is there? The spreadsheet program helps you to organize data, okay? So it is one of the most important programs that will help you to organize data, okay? So as we know, the spreadsheet program is a particular software that helps us to organize data, okay? So Excel basically is a software that is based on spreadsheet that helps us to organize data. Understood? Now, what are the things that Excel can help you to do? Excel can help you to make calculation, graphs, and develop reports. Okay? So it can help you to do calculation, it can help you to develop graphs, it can help you to develop reports. Okay? Understood? Now, if we see Microsoft Excel, I'm opening one up for you. Okay, so this is what Microsoft Excel looks like. Okay, if we see the window of Microsoft Excel, it is made up of rows and columns, where you can see A, B, C, D are the rows, whereas 1, 2, 3, 4, these are the columns. Okay, A, B, C, D are the columns, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are the rows. Okay, understood? So Excel, what did we learn? Then Excel is a spreadsheet program. What is the meaning of spreadsheet? It is a software that collects and organizes data. It can help us to make any calculation and develop reports. Okay, now what is the next terminology that we are going to learn? It is workbook. Okay, now the spreadsheet file, the entire file is known as workbook and has 255 worksheets. Let me open up again. If you can see here, that is, this is one Excel sheet, and this Excel sheet is actually known as sheet 1 and sheet 2. Okay, it is named in this way: sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3. Okay, now this Excel sheet that is there, all right, this sheet 1, sheet 2, and sheet 3, like this, there are 255 sheets which consist of, very important data you have to remember here, which consist of 16,384 columns and about 10,48,576 rows. So 16,384 columns to 10,48,576 rows are applicable in that of Excel. Okay, so as I told you, all the columns are marked with their heading, that is A, B, C, D, E. Okay, and whereas the row heading starts numerical right from the number 1. Okay, now what is cell? Let us see. The intersection of a row and a column is called a cell. For example, A cell is the basic unit. So if suppose, what is a cell? Let us understand by Excel itself. Suppose this cell is called A4. Why is this cell called A4? Let us see. Because see, it is present in the column A and cell number 4. That is why it is called cell A4. Column A, cell number 4. That is why A4. This is the intersection of column and that of the row. Here the column is A and intersection with row number 4. That is why the cell is called A4. Okay. Now, what are the uses of Excel? I already told you, use for manipulating numbers, any form of calculation, can be performed with the help of Microsoft Excel. It helps us to organize data. All the data that we collect are completely organized in Excel. Okay. We can store data in workbook. We can store huge amount of data in workbook, in fact. And we can also share this data in form of PDF as well as HTML. Okay. So I hope you have understood both the pages 98 and 99. This was just an introduction class. Now I'm giving you certain questions to solve. Okay. The first question I have you in your homework is, what is Microsoft Excel? Next question is, what is spreadsheet? The third question is, what is a cell? Add one more question with what is a cell. Give example. Apart from that, we can take another question. What is Or you can write this question. How many rows and columns are present in Excel? And lastly, with the fifth question that I would like all of you to encounter or face it, okay? What are the uses of Excel? Okay. As I told you, this was just an introduction class. So I want all of you to please go through both the pages here. Okay. Please copy down the homework question. Please take screenshot of this window here. Okay. And in that way, you all will be able to do the homework also. Okay. I hope all of you have taken the screenshot. All of you must send the homework by evening time. Okay. So I request all of you to please go through page number 98 and 99 before doing all these questions once again. So please give me feedback that you have understood this topic for today or not. And if you haven't, we'll do again a recap of this chapter and this particular topic. Okay. Thank you all students for listening to me today, and hope you enjoyed today's class, and please go through the pages 98 and 99. This is your computer teacher, Devdeep sir, thanking you for having your patience in watching today's class. Thank you.